As parents, we tend to influence our kids quite a lot. Children don't have the same perceptions as us. If you say a food isn't very nice, then they'll probably take that on board. Our job is to make people know that hospitality industry is a worthwhile industry going into. In Britain today, there's lots of diversity. Lots of chefs are experimenting with lots of flavors, textures, and the world has opened up over the sort of 10, 15, even 20 years. So as chefs, our job is getting a little bit harder because we've got to know what we're cooking. People are demanding more sort of trendy food. They want anything from Thai, Japanese, Italian, French, Middle Eastern. I mean, it's pretty endless. So I'm at this stage in my life now where passing on knowledge is so important. So I've set up several training academies over the years, trying to help, working with colleges. We need to look after the future. And it's something that a lot of chefs, the older chefs, need to shout about. We need to say, we need to pass on that knowledge. I've been working with the Falcon now for a couple of years, and it's been wonderful training all the chefs. For me, it's been a project as a consultant chef that I've really, really enjoyed. The one thing I've learned as being a consultant chef is you learn from everyone. I'm going to do a ribeye steak. I'm going to marinate the steak in a Japanese type of marinade with miso and with hoisin sauce. I'm going to serve it with a sushi cake, asparagus, furry cake, and a mango chili salsa. The first thing we're going to do is we're going to make the marinade. All the ingredients in, that'll be the ginger, the garlic, the mirin, and also the hoisin. Leave the steak in there for about sort of 10, 15 minutes. This is a very quick marinade. You can leave it overnight if you want, entirely up to you. The sushi cake I've already made, I'm going to press that into a ring. I'm then going to pan fry that. While that's pan frying, I'm going to cook some asparagus. Asparagus is just going to be left in the pan just to cook very, very gently, just for a bit of crunch. And then I'm going to add a Japanese avocado. Now the Japanese avocado will be sliced like a flower, it'll be fanned out, and that goes on top of the cake. Then I'm going to make my mango chili salsa. Now my mango chili salsa has mango in it, has garlic in it, it has some ginger in it, has some oil in it, it has wonderful herbs, so it bursts with flavor. Then I'll cook my steak, and as my steak is cooking, I will assemble the dish. Last but not least, I put a little seasoning over called furry cake. The furry cake is a mixture of toasted nori seaweed, sesame seeds, a little bit of salt, and just a very small bit of sugar. And that gives you a lovely umami flavor, and that's the finished dish. The most important step for this dish is to have a beautiful bit of beef, because as we've said, the beef is the star of the show. I want to taste that lovely glaze. All the other bits of the dish are fantastic, but they enhance the flavor of the beef. And that's what the Japanese do very, very well. West Country beef and lamb is so important for me, to use the best beef and lamb from the West Country. Sourceability, traceability, excellent flavor, excellent pastures for the animals to graze on. West Country beef and lamb, for me, is some of the finest in the world.